Hey everybody, I'm Chef Tom with ATBBQ.com, and today I'll be making barbecue bacon cheeseburgers. The barbecue bacon cheeseburger is one of those really basic recipes that every grill master should have in their back pocket. I mean, there's nothing terribly fancy about it, but there are a few key elements that really set it apart. The first of which is the crispy fried onion straws, and that's what we're gonna get started with. We're gonna do three burgers today, and half of a yellow onion should be plenty for that quantity. What I'm gonna try and do is just shave this onion as thin as possible. And then as we break this up, we can move on into the dredge process. We'll start off with a half cup of all-purpose flour. Then you wanna add a little bit of seasoning to it. We'll go with a couple tablespoons of our Cattleman's Grill California tri-tip. So nice, salty, savory flavors in there. And in this other bowl, we're gonna put some buttermilk down, about probably half to three quarters of a cup. So we'll switch these around here. We've got a handful of onions go into the buttermilk. Give them a nice toss. And then into the flour mixture. So that's coated nicely, it's sticking to it. And from there, we're gonna go into some hot oil. So we got the Lodge skillet. It's an 8-inch skillet, about halfway full of vegetable oil. Our oil's running at about 350 to 375 degrees. That hot oil immediately opens up the aroma of the tri-tip seasoning. You get that pepper and the garlic, the onion all just popping out already. Now, especially when you're working in a skillet as small as this one with as little oil as we're using, anytime you add something to the skillet, the temperature wants to drop. So feel free to go ahead and bump up the heat just a little bit to compensate. And there's that golden brown color we're looking for to finish it off. All right, so there we go. Our fried crispy onion straws. Take the 10, 15 minutes it takes to make them. It's totally worth it. The flavor alone makes it worth it as far as the saltiness and the garlic and the pepper bite. But the really important thing that this adds to the burger is texture. That crunchiness is invaluable in the end product. Let's go check out the grill setup now and get started on our bacon. Today we're cooking on the Yoder Smoker's YS640 pellet grill, set to 425 degrees and set up for direct grilling. Now we've got grill grates in place on the left side and a griddle in place on the right, and we're gonna utilize both of these. Now with this setup, the bacon's actually gonna take the longest to cook, so we're gonna start that first. And while this gets started, we're gonna go form our burger patties. We're going for 1/3-pound burger patties on this burger today. And then as far as the patty itself goes, there's really nothing special to it. We're gonna form it by hand, but we're not gonna add a bunch of other stuff to it. We're just gonna let it be a beefy burger patty. This is 80-20 ground chuck. So the goal here is to get these patties pressed out pretty wide because they're gonna shrink up quite a bit as they cook. And we want them to be about the same size as the bun in the end. We're gonna season these today with the Our butts are smoking our beef rub. This is one of my favorite brisket rubs. Not too heavy. Get both sides. All right, let's let that set up for a few minutes. And we'll go ahead and get our buns buttered. All right, so I've just got some melted butter here. We're gonna brush onto our brioche buns. Now this is gonna go smoothest if you've got your mise en place, if you've got everything ready to go, everything's in its place. So starting out, we've got burgers seasoned up and ready to go. We've got burger buns that are buttered and ready to go on the griddle as soon as the bacon comes off. Our cheese is ready. We've got yellow and white American that's gonna go on the burger after we flip it. And then when we bring everything back at the end, we've got our mayo our barbecue sauce, and of course, our crispy fried onions. All right, we're getting some nice browning on the bacon. It's not cooking too fast, which is great because the slices won't shrink up as much. So we're just turning to get this brown nice and evenly. A few more minutes and these will be done. This bacon looks perfect. All right, so I'm just gonna scrape off some of this excess grease so we can toast our buns over here on the griddle. And then we're coming right in with our burger patties. Over direct flame. We give this a few minutes to get some grill marks on there. See if you can get a peek at that. Yeah, it's looking good. We're gonna rotate those to get a really nice crosshatch. And at the same time, these buns that are getting toasted really nice on the left, we're gonna move them over so that the ones on the right can get the same treatment. Because we're not quite there yet. Now pretty much immediately after we flip these, I'm gonna add the cheese. I wanna give it time to melt before this thing's done cooking. We don't want to overcook our burgers. I wouldn't go past about 150, 155 on the internal. All right, the burgers are about done, so I'm just going to steam this cheese to finish this. We'll add some water to the grate, put a bowl over the top. All right, we got a great melt on these. Let's pull them off the grill. All right, so let's put these things together. We're gonna start with a little mayo on the bottom bun. Then we're gonna hit it with the bacon. Now we've got our burger patty with the melted cheese on top. And that melted cheese is going to help hold all of our onions in place. Last thing we're gonna do here is hit it with some barbecue sauce. I've got the Smoke on Wheels bootleg. This is a bourbon-infused barbecue sauce. And we'll just spoon that right over the top. That's it, top bun, and we are done. And that's how we do the barbecue bacon cheeseburger. Oh man. So juicy, so flavor packed. Sweet, it's salty. My goodness, that crunch from the onions and the griddled buns, unreal. Tons of flavor. I gotta love this burger. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Be sure to check out atbbq.com where you can find a good deal of the products featured in this recipe for sale and available for purchase. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that subscribe button. And if you have any questions or comments or there's anything you'd like to see me cook, let me know in the comment section down below. And let's be good to one another. For more recipes, tips, and techniques, head over to thesauce.atbbq.com. All things barbecue, where barbecue legends are made.